My dear brothers and sisters, young and old, at present the propaganda is made that the purpose of life is to eat, drink and be merry. A young man thinks, if I get a good degree, good job, nice house, beautiful wife, then my life is successful. But actually, this is not the purpose of life. Purpose of life is to understand who I am. If you ask someone who you are, he will say, I am Ram Lal, I am Shyam Lal, I am Mr. John, I am this, I am that. No. Purpose of life is to understand who I am. So who I am? I am not this body. I am soul. And the purpose of life is to understand that soul. Through this body, God has given us develop intelligence. Intelligence is there in all the species of life. They all have intelligence. But their intelligence is limited up to eating, sleeping, mating and defending. They cannot go beyond this. But we human beings, we have discriminatory intelligence. We can discriminate. Here is my mother, here is my sister, here is my daughter, here is my wife. Animal can't. Animal take his mother as wife, sister as wife, daughter as wife. So, the wrong propaganda is there all over. People have become animalistic. They're only thinking of sense enjoyment. And too much sense enjoyment is the cause of all the problems. The problems at present, our society, our people are facing due to the too much sense enjoyment. Purpose of life is to understand the soul, is to realize that soul. But day by day, people are forgetful of this point. Nobody thinks I am soul, I am not this body. Everybody is trying to enjoy. Everybody is thinking like this. And the result is in front of us. So many suicides, so many problems, so many crimes. They are going on all over India and all over the world. So if we try to understand the soul through proper guidance, so our problems will minimize and our life can turn from bad to good. But as long as this will go on, life will be bad, life will be miserable. People are becoming miserable. You see that young man in the schools committing suicides. In America, the shooting is very prevalent. In the school, student shoots 10, 20 other students. Why this is there? Only because they are only thinking the purpose of life is to enjoy. They are not thinking the purpose of life is to understand the self, is to understand the soul, is to realize the soul. Nobody is thinking. So, through this video, I like to convey this message to all of you. Please try to understand this. We are after this bodily enjoyment. But how long we will do this? Radha Sri Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, he is advising us, janma mritu jara vyadhi dukkha doshanu darshanam. You see the problem of birth, problem of death, problem of old age, problem of disease, problem of so many difficulties. Actually, this material world is declared by Krishna as dukkhalya, place of miseries. And we are not behaving properly, we are not acting properly, we are acting on the bodily platform, and we are forgetful of the purpose. So I like to convey all of you, my brothers and mothers, young and old, please try to understand this. This Bharat Bhumi, this India, is land of austerity. Why to perform austerity? To purify our existence, to purify our consciousness. Austerity means trouble is taken for spiritual advancement. Just like to get up before 4 in the morning, take bath, remember God. Now the people, you know, they sleep till 8 o'clock. They have to go 8:30 to the office or work, sleep till 8. When they get up, running here and there, and so many difficulties. So, purpose of life is to understand who I am, from where I came, where I shall go after death, and what is God, Krishna, and what is my relationship with Krishna. This is the purpose. Purpose, but we are thinking, is not the purpose. Animals are also busy in eating, sleeping, waiting, and defending. But the human beings, they should go beyond this. They should not stay animalistic platform. They go further, they go beyond. Why I am here? Why I am put into so many difficulties? And there is a solution. According to our Vedic culture, which is the ancient and the oldest, older than Christianity, older than Judaism, older than any other culture on earth, is old. And old is gold, and gold is never old. So, we have to take the advice from Bhagavad Gita. Lord Sri Krishna is advising us. Mainly, in the purpose people are thinking, a man is thinking of a woman, and woman is thinking of a man. When they meet, they mate and get more entangled into the material perplexities. Our main attraction is the sex life. And the Western way is free mixing. Actually, Britishers to dominate India and dominate Indian people, they started here free education. Boys and girls, they study together, is not good. A woman is explained in the Shastra like a fire, and man is like a butter. When you put butter near the fire, it will melt. It won't stay like that. So, separation. In our ancient ways, women were given separate education, and their education was very basic. Men were given separate, and they were very happy men were given, boys were given education in the Gurukuls. In the Gurukuls, it was explained, in the Bhagavatam it is mentioned, Kaumar Acharte Pragyo Dharman Bhagavatanihi Durlava Manusha Janama Tat Api Trubumatadam. There was one devotee, great devotee, Prahlad Maharaj. When his teachers, Shand and Amarka, will go out of the classroom, Prahlad will make everybody chant Hare Krishna, make everybody understand about soul and the super soul. So his classmate will say, Prahlad, this is our time to study and to enjoy and play. We will think of God when we will grow old. So Prahlad Maharaj used to give the answer, no. We should take to this spiritual life. Kaumar means from the age of 5, not later than 5. Kaumar acharte pragyo dharman bhagavatanihi durlabha manushyanam. Because this human body is very rare to achieve. Have anybody seen a person has died and he came back? No. When we will give up this body, we are not going to come back in this body. We may come back in different bodies, we don't know. Not necessarily human body, it can be animal, it can in any species of life. So from the age of 5, Prahlad Maharaj is teaching, one should take to the spiritual life. This is the purpose of life. To understand who I am, from where I came, where I shall go after death, what is God, and what is my relationship with God. From the very beginning of life, student was given this education. This is the purpose. Now, education is totally different. This present education is to fill the belly, and sometimes they cannot do that also. Big degrees they have, but no job. What is the use of these degrees when a person cannot fill his belly by these degrees? PhD or MBBS or FRCS, this, that, so many degrees. So, Prahlad Maharaj explained the purpose of life. From the age of 5, we should start worshipping the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. Krishna, Vishnu, both are same. And try to re-establish our forgotten relationship with Krishna. This is the purpose of life. And how we can do this? This can be done by simply, in Kali Yuga, process is very simple. One should begin chanting the holy name. One can chant any holy name, any name, no problem. But this Maha Mantra is recommended. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. This Maha Mantra is recommended. And by chanting this, what will happen? We will come in touch with the Almighty Lord Sri Krishna through His name. Hare is Radha, Krishna is all attractive, Ram is a reservoir of pleasure. So I humbly request, just try. Those who are very confused, disturbed, those who are committing suicide, try to chant this Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And see the difference yourself. There's no blind following. You don't have to follow blindly. You can see yourself. There is a difference. There is a change. So many people around the world are seeing this, and our Indian people can also see. Please try to chant Hare Krishna and perfect your life. And perfection is in understanding the self. And self can be understood by chanting Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, it is something which you can directly perceive, and we have seen. There was one man, I happened to meet him in US. He said, I was thinking to commit suicide. But when I came in contact with Hare Krishna people, I got the Bhagavad Gita. I read Bhagavad Gita too. I said, oh no, what I was going to do, it is wrong. Purpose of life is to understand who I am, from where I came, where I shall go after death. Everything is very nicely explained. So he was saved from this committing suicide. And nowadays, so many problems, so many people are dying, doing different things. Some are taking poison, some are jumping from the hills, some are jumping from the big building. Too much frustration. When we stay on the bodily platform, then frustration will be there. Bodily platform cannot give us any peace. On the bodily platform, we will be simply frustrated. So try to get out of this bodily platform by coming in contact with this Hare Krishna mantra. And you will see the difference. Very simple. And suppose if you think, our unclean mind may think, oh, what benefit will be there? If there is no benefit, then there will be no loss also. But benefit is definitely there, which so many people have seen around the world. And we have met those people, and we have seen those people. So please, chant this mantra. And before you chant Hare Krishna mantra, there are two more mantras you should chant. One is Panchatattva mantra. Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Sri Krishna Chaitanya is Krishna himself. Nityananda is Balaram. Advaita Acharya Mahavishnu. Gadadhar Radha and Srivas Naraji. They have appeared to help we fallen people of Kali Yuga. So we should pray to them, and they don't take offense. Generally we are very offensive, but they are very kind to the people of Kali Yuga. If you chant the Panchatattva mantra, then they don't take offenses. And before you chant the Panchatattva, you should pray to the Srila Prabhupada, who has given us all this beautiful spiritual life, purpose of life, who has explained, who has given us volumes of books. And you can read and you can see yourself how informative these books are, how scientific these books are. You will see yourself. And it can turn your life from bad to good. You can become a good person, and you can see in the purpose of life. That purpose of life is to become self-realized, is to understand Krishna, is to re-establish or forgotten relationship with Krishna. You can see that. It's not difficult to see. And so many people are saying. And let me tell you that people in the Western world, they were busy in merrymaking. But they were frustrated. Frustrated like anything. I was once in Chicago. There was one boy who used to come to the temple Sunday. He was from Bengal. He was a very brilliant boy. These Americans, you know, toppers and Indian toppers, they gave them the scholarship. Boys and girls, they go for study in US. And this boy, one day he met me in Chicago, in our temple. He said, Swamiji, when I come to the temple, I feel different. I feel peaceful. But when I stay in my campus, I am depressed. I am in depression. So please, try to understand and make your life happy, peaceful by taking the spiritual life as a purpose of life. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.